Hi, I am Dr. Selvaraj, your surgical educator from Malaysia. Welcome back to my series of surgical teaching video casts. These are meant mainly for undergraduate medical students doing the surgical clerkship rotation. I promise you will become competent in clinical problem solving and surgical decision making if you are going to watch these videos over and over again. Today in this episode, I am going to talk one more topic on trauma, that is the blunt abdominal trauma. I am not going to talk about the individual organ injuries, but in this video, I'll be talking about the overall approach to a patient with blunt abdominal injury. So, the objective of my lecture is, after watching this video, all of you should be able to understand what are the different types of abdominal trauma and what are the various organs involved in this trauma, what are the clinical features in case of blunt abdominal trauma, what workup or investigations you must do to clinch the diagnosis, what treatment or how to manage these patients. Of course, at the end of the video, I have also included a treatment algorithm for blunt abdominal trauma. I have not included any individual organ injuries. This algorithm is only for the overall management of how to approach a case of blunt abdominal trauma. So this is a major surgical emergency, this blunt abdominal trauma. Patient is often unconscious, causing difficulty in arriving at the diagnosis. It is also associated with majority of these cases, also associated with head injury, chest injury, pelvic and bone injuries as well. This is called polytrauma. Abdominal injuries, it may involve the organs, maybe the solid organs like liver, spleen and kidney, pancreas, or the hollow viscous like the bowel, or the retroperitoneal big blood vessels like aorta and IVC, as well as the mesenteric tongue. This also can happen. 25% of these cases, the blunt abdominal trauma patients, they need some sort of surgical treatment. First, you have to do a surgical exploration and you have to find out what is the injury inside the abdomen. So mainly it is compression injury. The blunt injury abdomen is, it could be a compression injury producing seat belt injury. Majority of this is what you are seeing here, the seat belt impression. You can see it over the chest and over the abdomen. If you are seeing this sort of injuries, definitely these patients are going to have some sort of internal organ injury as well. It can produce the compression injury, just a contusion. See, this is the liver. So this is a contusion injury, or it could be a laceration, or it could be a frank bleeding. You can see the frank blood only inside, and that is called hemoperitoneum. Or if it is a solid organ, this could be a subcapsular hematoma in case of spleen or in case of kidney. Suppose if the mechanism of injury is deceleration injury, that is notorious to produce torn mesentery and perforated bowel. What are the injury type? This is for overall abdominal trauma. This could be a blunt injury. Most commonly injured organ in blunt injury is spleen. The first part of jejunum, iliojunction often gives way because of deceleration injury. So penetrating injury could be a stab injury or a missile injury. Most commonly the injured organ now is liver in penetrating injury. It could be just an injury to the only the abdominal wall also. So you have to, this is the stab injury you are seeing. These are the different organs. Even the diaphragm may get injured in this blunt injury abdomen because of sudden increase in intra-abdominal pressure. So what are the clinical features? What are the symptoms? You can see that pattern of the seat belt over the chest and the abdominal skin. And this is called the pattern aberration, or this is also known as London sign. Patient may or may not have abdominal distension, and patients, majority of these patients will have features of the specific individual organ injury. Suppose if it is splenic injury, you will have the characteristic feature for the splenic injury like the curse sign, etc., which I am doing exclusively a separate video for each organ injury like the splenic injury, the liver injury, the kidney injury, all these things. I am going to produce separate exclusive videos. And coming to the signs, definitely there will be tenderness in the abdomen and maybe rebound tenderness, guarding, and if guarding may be there. And suppose if the bowel is perforated, definitely the patient will develop rigidity all over the abdomen. If there is blood in the hemoperitoneum, then there may be flank fullness and dull note may be there. Majority of these patients are they are losing blood. This is an ongoing loss. So the patient will present with the shock. So coming to the investigation, what are the investigations you can do to clinch the diagnosis? Of course, the gold standard investigation for blunt injury abdomen is, nowadays it is called FAST scan, or this is nothing but the ultrasound of the abdomen. FAST scan stands for focus abdominal sonography for trauma. Okay, this is what you have to do. Focus abdominal sonography for trauma. I have already made an exclusive video on the FAST scan, e-FAST scan. I have made a separate video, and I request my viewers to go and watch that video also. E-FAST scan. I have done already a separate video. This is a rapid, non-invasive, portable ultrasound focusing on pericardial, hepatic, splenic and pelvic areas. This is the classical FAST scan. Nowadays, we are doing extended FAST scan where we include the thorax also. This detects only if the, the amount of blood or the quantity of blood is more than 100 ml. Then only you can pick up with this ultrasound. It is not reliable for bowel injuries or penetrating injuries. This is only for blunt injury abdomen. This is the best investigation. So this is the classical one, where here this is the right hypochondrium, this is the left hypochondrium, this is the hypogastric area, and this is the epigastric area. These are the four areas we do in the classical FAST scan. Nowadays, we have included the thorax also. So now we are examining the 8 areas. So here the same thing, here right hypochondrium, left hypochondrium, epigastric region and hypogastric region. Apart from that, the right side thorax, 2 areas, the base of the right side thorax and the apex of the right side thorax. Similarly, the base of the left side thorax and the apex of the left side thorax. So in order to find out any, bleeding or any injury in the thorax, you can make out by doing this one. So here, this is what is called extended FAST scan. This is what we are doing nowadays. Here you are seeing one of the pictures of FAST scan in the left upper quadrant, okay, region, where you are seeing some free fluid. Probably, most probably, this is a splenic injury. The next, the investigation is CT of the abdomen, where this is to assess the retroperitoneal injury or the solid organ injury. It is highly specific. You can see here, you can pick up the lacerations in the spleen and the frank bleeding here that you can make out, or you can make out an injury in the liver, or you can make out an injury in the kidney also. So this is a if your patient is stable, if they are stable hemodynamically, then only you have to do CT abdomen. If your patient is not stable, then you have to rely only on the FAST scan. The another investigation is DPL or diagnostic peritoneal lavage. Nowadays we are not doing it. This DPL is supplanted by the fast scan nowadays. So nowadays we are not doing this DPL, but in some of the examiners or may ask you what is DPL. So all of you must know what is this DPL. This is a procedure of choice in physiologically unstable patient with blunt abdominal trauma, but now we are doing only fast scan. Example, those who are having spinal injury or those who are unconscious, but nowadays we are doing the fast scan and not the DPL. Procedure, you have to infuse 1 liter of normal saline or Ringer lactate into the peritoneal cavity via the subumbilical lavage catheter. That is what you have to put inside. You have to make a subumbilical incision. You have to incise the linea alba and put the catheter inside. And you have to infuse 1 liter of normal saline or Ringer lactate. The patient position is changed from time to time and from side to side. And then the fluid aspirate from the abdomen should be assessed. What are the criteria for the positive lavage? Number one, if the aspirate contains frank blood of more than 10 ml or if it contains RBC of more than 1 lakh per cubic millimeter or the WBC count of more than 500 per cubic millimeter or the amylase level is more than 175 international unit or presence of either bile, bacteria, food particles or foreign body. So all these things are criteria to say the DPL is a positive one. But nowadays this is supplanted by the fast scan or the e-fast scan. The another very good, investigation is diagnostic laparoscopy. If you are still in doubt, even after the fast scan or the DPL, but DPL we are not doing it, you can go for diagnostic laparoscopy. So usually there is a emergency theater just adjacent to the A&E. So you can shift the patient immediately to the adjacent emergency theater and you can do the diagnostic laparoscopy. Here in this patient, you are seeing a splenic injury. You are seeing hematoma there. This is the spleen. You are seeing lot of blood. Blood is clotted already. So this is what you can easily make out the injury. Okay, whether it is injury to the spleen or liver or kidney, everything you can make out by doing this diagnostic laparoscopy. But you have to do it only if the fast scan, both the fast scan and the CT scan is unequivocal. Then only you have to do this diagnostic laparoscopy. And this is a slide which is showing the comparison between the three main investigations for the blunt abdominal trauma. One is the diagnostic peritoneal lavage, which I told you nowadays we are not doing it. Another one is the ultrasound or the fast scan and the computer tomography. Computer tomography you should do only if your patient is stable, hemodynamically stable. Otherwise, you should do only the fast scan. I request, I am not going into the detail of this table. I request my viewers to pause the video and read all these points. So what are the real indications for the surgical exploration? Or when will you do surgery in a case of abdominal trauma? If your patient is having hypotension without other known causes, or the bleeding is there through the wound, or continuous bleeding in the nasogastric tube, evisceration of the abdominal content through the open wound, or air under diaphragm in blunt abdominal injury. All these are indications for you to do the exploratory laparotomy. You must do if one of these conditions are there. So how will you manage a patient with blunt abdominal trauma? I am not talking about the individual organ injuries, but here I am going to talk overall how will you approach a case of abdominal trauma. So after doing the laparotomy, you have to do what is called the injury evaluation. You have to look for both the severity and the number of organs injured. You must also look for the hematocrite. If it is more than 6 grams, tissue oxygenation is usually sufficient. If it is less than that, then you have to give blood transfusion. General message, you can start a central line if for volume replacement. You can do bladder catheterization to find out the urinary output. And you can also give systemic antibiotic, broad spectrum antibiotics. Another important thing is, if blood is not available, you can transfuse patient's own blood, and this is called autotransfusion, which is life-saving. What is the actual procedure? Blood from the abdominal cavity is sucked into a sterile bottle containing 150 ml of 3.8% sodium citrate dextrose solution. Okay, this is what they are collecting. You can use a big syringe to suck the blood from the peritoneal cavity, and you can inject it into this container, which is containing 150 ml of 3.8% sodium citrate dextrose solution. So after collecting enough blood here, you can transfuse it through the peripheral vein. This is one method where we can use a syringe and we can do it. But this is a commercially available apparatus to collect the blood for auto transfusion. And another thing is, you must do an exploratory laparotomy. The incision is usually upper midline. You can go even up to the pubic symphysis. The objective is, you want to evaluate the extent of the injury. You are doing what is called exploratory laparotomy. So you have to do, if there is any active bleeding, immediately you have to try to control it. And then you have to reconstruct the affected area. Whatever may be the affected organ, you have to reconstruct, or you have to try to stop that one. This is the laparotomy you are seeing here. This is the exploratory laparotomy. You are exploring all the abdominal organs for evidence of the injury. So prior to the execution, the entire abdomen is inspected, palpated for any additional missed injuries. You have to do a thorough clinical exam, and then only you have to do the exploratory laparotomy. You should assess the diaphragm. You should look for the lesser sac collection in anywhere there, retroperitoneum, portal veins, liver, spleen, kidney, duodenum, pancreas, bladder and rectum. So you have to explore the whole abdomen, including the retroperitoneal area. If you are unable to find out the exact cause, okay, you can drain the fluid via the tubes on either side of the abdomen. You put two big drainage tubes, you can drain whatever fluid is there. Or you can go for just stoma. If there is a hollow viscous injury, okay, you can produce this stoma. Types and indication, you can go for jejunostomy for all major abdominal injuries, or gastrostomy along with jejunostomy for duodenal and pancreatic injuries. This is what you are seeing. This is the gastrostomy you are seeing here, and this is a jejunostomy. And the management of individual organs like splenic injury, liver injury, kidney injury, the bowel injury and all, I am going to make individual exclusive videos for each organ injuries. What are the post-op messes you can do? You can give blood transfusion, sepsis and renal failure management. Of course, for sepsis, you have to give broad spectrum antibiotic. For renal failure, okay, you can start dialysis. And you have to correct both the acid-base imbalance and the electrolyte imbalance. You have to correct it. You have to prevent DVT, prophylaxis. You have to give. For that, the low molecular weight heparin you can give. And you should be able to manage the disseminated intravascular coagulation also. Of course, for all your surgical patients, you should give adequate nutrition. If patient is unable to take, orally, then you have to start total parenteral nutrition at least. So this is an algorithm for how to manage a case of blunt abdominal trauma. So this is a suspected abdominal trauma in a 25-year-old female patient who is ejected from a motor vehicle complaining of back pain and low abdominal pain. Okay, this is the patient. So you have to look for the vital signs. You have to take as much of history as possible. Initial stabilization of the patient is very important, and then initial abdominal examination. You have to do definitely, this is the the investigation of choice. Nowadays, whether the patient is stable or not, you should do the focus abdominal sonography or the extended FAST scan. Okay, if the extended FAST scan is demonstrating free fluid in the peritoneal cavity, that you have to do a exploratory laparotomy. If there is no free fluid and if the patient is hemodynamically stable, no free fluid but patient is not hemodynamically stable, then also you have to do exploratory laparotomy. Suppose if the patient is not having any free fluid and patient is also hemodynamically stable, then you should go for CT scan. In the CT scan, if there is active extravasation of the dye and if the patient is hemodynamically, but the patient is not hemodynamically stable, again go for exploratory laparotomy. Suppose if the patient is hemodynamically stable, you can do angiography and you can try this therapeutic embolization to stop the bleeding. After that, you can observe the patient and you can do serial abdominal examination. Suppose if the CT scan is not showing any injury, okay, you can observe the patient and you can do serial abdominal examination. Suppose if it is failure, then you have to do exploratory laparotomy. Okay, suppose if the CT scan is showing free fluid without extravasation, you can do observation or better do a DPL or DPA. If it is negative, okay, you can discharge the patient. If it is positive, okay, go for laparoscopy or exploratory laparotomy. So this is the algorithm for how to approach or how to manage a abdominal trauma, blunt abdominal trauma patients. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you think that these videos are very helpful, kindly subscribe to this channel and share these videos in your social media. Please click the bell button also to get notified regarding my latest uploads. Thank you once again for watching this video. Let us meet in yet another video. Until then, bye bye.